Hey guys, gals, let's build Pegasus Flying Horse by LEGO DREAMZzz. This is set number 71457, contains 482 bricks, retails for $49.99, and this set was provided by the LEGO group for review. And that's essentially what we're building there. And yeah, and we'll take a look at that. I already have bag one keyed up, ready to go. And it just jumps right on in here. And we also do get a set of stickers and some wings and a cape. So let's begin with bag one. Let's build it. And yes, I thought this one looked like it was going to be fun, but when I did the unboxing, it's going to be dreary colors. So you have been forewarned. And you got to do our usual minifigure, which I think she's probably the only one that's got some color to her, and the rest of it's just all bland colors. And yeah, I've been trying to get things done here. Matter of fact, I'm editing, I think part three of that shark ship, and then I'm editing the unboxing for the shark ship. And then I'm doing this one now just to get it out of the way. And before we can do any of the fun stuff, which is probably the most exciting part of the whole build so far, is the figures. The rest of it's not going to be too good. So, yeah, you got to do all this. And you got the voodoo doll base. Stick that in there. And I'm going to be honest. I've been known to be blunt. This set is the last few sets, he's been boring, except for two of them. So this one here is another one of those nightmare things that we're going to have to put together. And yeah, I'm not really in the mood. I think that's how that goes together. And that's an ugly thing there. It's even got horns, too. Yeah, so we'll be here for about 30 minutes putting together the figures. I think there might be four figures in total. Well, I'm hoping I'm getting that in there right. And I got to make sure I do it correctly because I always have somebody who will throw a fit because I don't get them done right. So, yeah, I've been trying to get a lot of these sets done. And when I looked across the room and, you know, I have a couple ideas I want to build. And then I saw these and I thought, well, I'm going to have to turn the head is in the right way. It just doesn't show any eyes through there. Do I really care? Not really. I saw a bunch of stuff. When we're not done with him yet. I forgot. We got to do something else with him. And I saw these and I thought, okay, more belly aching. Yeah, this shit's coming apart. Yeah, just let everybody know now on these are not going to be family friendly. I'm not going to be using some very explicit language. You may just hear the word, the S word come out of my mouth, but I'm not going to censor these really anymore. These videos are not meant for children to watch by any means. We're not supposed to be cussing people out or bullying people here. Well, maybe for the set. But and no, we're not done yet. And Basil, we're supposed to build some kind of flying dark side. Look at this. This just falls apart. My Little Pony set, you know, I don't know what kid is going to want to build this. In fact, I wanted to sit down and watch The Walking Dead. Okay, now the eyes are showing through it. And I can't do that while I'm building this. So anyways, I got done, like I haven't even finished any of the, I haven't finished the full video installments on any of these yet. I've been mostly filming them. I've already edited a few of these and got them up on YouTube as uploads. and I proved a few of them, and I'm just kind of belly aching my way through these. These are not by any means fun at all. You know, for me anyways, they're just dark colors. So if you're into this dark colored stuff, yeah, there you go. But for myself, I'd rather be waiting in the long lines at the DMV than do this set. At least I'll get a variety. So anyways, I am no longer answering questions on where do I get my parts from anymore. This year is going to be the last year I put parts list on my haul videos. Because I'm getting that same question asked. I had one question asked on my campground. Where do I get the bushes from? And I just literally just had it. And I said, I just commented back. I said, dude, you need to watch my latest haul video. That'll answer your question. I will no longer answer questions regarding. If I see those, I'll just give it a. I'll give it a thumbs up and move on. Just let me know that I read it. I figure if more people don't watch those videos, I'm not even going to answer those questions anymore. I had another fan tell me, "Well, why would I waste my time watching those videos? Why would I waste my time answering the questions then?" You know, and you get to that point, that's sad. Okay, we're going to start here in the middle. And I don't want to make this to be some kind of a rant session, but yeah, you get the same questions asked. It's, you know, a lot of my veterans know where I get my stuff from. And which is kind of sad, because a lot of people who are new to my channel, they don't know how I do things, and that's understandable. But yeah. Is this some kind of a cage? And then we have to swing these up very slowly here. This is not going to, well, maybe it's not too terribly bad. Most of these I have built so far have been robust in terms of they're very durable. I haven't had anything fall off. That's not too bad. Matter of fact, that'd make a great idea for like a lighthouse. Just wrap all the way around that would be pretty cool. You can find a way to put some glass elements and it would be pretty cool there. I forgot to put the piece on the top. Well, we'll just stick the finger in there and we'll just do that. Yeah. Oh, am I building two of these? Let's make sure. Okay. Yeah, so I'm trying to plow through as many of these as I can. I want to get back to customs. I know some people have already told me they're getting tired of the reviews. Why don't I just do customs full time? You know, yeah, I would like to do that too, but at least I'm getting parts for these type of builds. So just imagine, you know, having the extra parts. I gotta make three of these here. There's medium pieces and small pieces with this set, so if you're not a fan of these type of small parts and specialty pieces, this is probably not gonna be a set for you. Did I forget to give that guy a fork in his hand? Okay. I've been trying to get done with a lot of dismantling of sets and sorting parts. Now I see why a lot of these guys who do this. And somebody just left a comment. And some of these guys, what I have been told, when they get a lot of sets like this, who are the ambassador thing, they just shove them inside of storage just to not see them again. And I've already got three large totes full of, and that's kind of creepy, three large totes full of sets. And I hadn't even got to parting them out yet, but I write down the set numbers and I, you know, reference my parts to them. And then what I'll do, okay, it's the large teeth, not these ones. what I'll do is if I need a part, I check sets that I have, and if they already have been deconstructed, they're in the collection. If they have not been deconstructed, then they're listed on my list that the parts are still on them. And that's what I've been doing. That's not a bad little idea for legs, for if you were to make a table or something, like a patio table or a dining room table. A little tall, but not a bad idea. And that goes on the bottom there. Let me make sure. Oh, the cross axle. Okay, I got that backwards. And that is going to be a pain to remove. This, you want to make sure your Technic pin is at the bottom. It goes down here. And it's pretty strong for the most part. Well, maybe not. This crap's already falling apart. Yeah, give me an old-fashioned Lego City house build any day. Yeah, this thing really is. Now this thing's really deformed. And no, I'm going to try hard not to say the F word in here. I've already said that enough already, and doing the editing on these. Maybe I should. I think that's how it's supposed to sit. Yep. And we're not done with it yet. We got to put wings on it. Everything here flies. And I'm kind of wanting just to get these out of the way here. Dude, if you're asking me a question, I really can't answer you right now. Although, maybe I should read them while I'm doing these, huh? I did have somebody ask me the other day, why does it take me so long to respond? I'm like, because I have a life off of YouTube. I would swear I would never get to be like those YouTubers, but it's going to be at the point one day where I may have to do it. Here it's okay, because see, I can read comments and then answer them here. But a lot of people don't like to do that. That thing just looks hideous. So what is that just supposed to be? Just some kind of decorative piece? It'll sit over there then. And then now we're going to do something else here. Yeah, because I'm running two computers right now. One that's processing and one that's editing a video. Like, I get done with this, I'll edit while I'm setting up the next bag or something. But I got everything keyed up here. And plus, this is going to be a one contentious build today. This is what we're going to do. I'm just going to sit here and build it until I'm done. Because it's got to be done. Yeah, so I've been looking at some more things to build in Lego. And there's plenty of ideas. I have the parts, just not in the right colors, which is typical for any Lego builder. You always have the parts, just not those colors. I hate when you can't pick these up off the ground and you don't want to scratch them up. So far, that thing's kind of fragile to put together. And yeah. Is this exciting to build? The colors are really kind of throwing me off here. It's just, it's all black parts, pretty much. Not all sets that have black pieces are going to be depressing to build, but something like this. Like cars and stuff are one thing. There we go. Not sure what that does. I can't even get to it. Maybe somebody's trying to contact me on something, huh? Do I have to get up and read it? I'm kind of confused here. Yep, and I still got a bunch of these built dream sets that I haven't finished doing yet. All right, so this actually goes like this. So I think there was a mirror of this too. But I'm not going to do that right now. I'll spare you guys and gals. That's probably the only color I've seen in here. Some kind of bat thing? Is this like a zoo bat or something? Yeah, so here's the deal. Last time we met, I got the pontoon boat building instructions. Everything's ready to go. It's up on Patreon. And speaking of that, Patreon now is going to allow us to open up storefronts. So if you don't want to pay the $5 a month for the building guide access and stuff like that, guess what? You can purchase building guides. I don't know how that's going to work yet. And my whole goal on that is, if they allow you to purchase a building guide, let's say you make an account, you purchase, and it keeps your purchase there. So let's say a year from now your computer crashes, you can download another copy. You don't have to buy one. That's my whole intent. I'm hoping that's what they're going to do. So if that's how Patreon is going to do that, then I'm going to use that. I still will keep Rebrickable. So, wait a minute, hold on. I got it right way. So if you're on Rebrickable and you'd rather buy from there, they're going to be the same price. Everything's the same. So that's how I'm doing it there. Let me take a look here. Sometimes I gotta match it up with the book. And so yeah, you can buy the manuals a la carte. Because I've been getting more requests for a la carte manuals than anything else. So pretty soon, that's what you'll be able to have access to. And yeah, some kind of evil looking Zubat thing. And we're building a Minecraft bed now, it looks like. And I know some have told me they don't want to buy anything. Why can't I just give them away for free? Well, free doesn't pay my bills. And two, I was never intending to sell those. But if you purchase one, you'll be able to ask questions about the build, or if you're having a hard time finding parts. Now, I had some questions asked, you know, why don't I provide, you know, why can't I sell the parts for those? Because a lot of the parts I use for my builds are shared amongst other builds. If I were to sell all the parts, I'd have to constantly buy more inventory, which would drive up the cost of the building guides. It would be very expensive, and that's why I don't do that. It's easier just to sell the PDF and let the user view it and stuff. And all my builds, for those who are my veteran viewers, all the parts exist. I don't use anything rare, anything exotic or anything. That's how it is. Oh, this is some kind of a bed. So the bed flies away, huh? And we're not done with this ugly creature. We got to make four bone things. So yeah, that's pretty much what it is. It was something that I opted into. It'd be a while before I get the storefront done. And which platform do I prefer? It depends on the user. You know, I've already had a few of you tell me you don't want to pay a monthly fee. That's $60 a month, or $60 a year. And, you know, that's, to some, that's a lot of money, especially to today. The way everything is, or $60 can't fill your car up with gas, or can't buy, I don't think even $60 can buy you a bag of groceries anymore. That's sad. I picked the wrong time to do all those, huh? But you're basically paying for the quality of my time to put those books together. because they are not cheap to produce in terms of time. I've already got a lot of people asking about the tiny house. And I'm like, it's on Patreon. Like, oh, well, can you tell me when you're going to have it on something else? I'm like, I don't know when. And that's it. Shows them like this here, and I think you're supposed to bend them like this. And that takes care of him right there. And that's pretty creepy, huh? And essentially right now, so far, bag one does all this stuff. We have forks in here. What are the forks for? I don't know. I'll put that in here for safekeeping. Okay, we're going to move on to bag two. And so far, it's an isolated family build. I have a feeling, though, bag two is going to be the big thing. I don't know. It could be family build, and it'll get a high ranking despite the bleak colors. Okay. Do our usual minifigures. Looks like they're dragging this one out. Oh, at least it's not one of those. We have a cape to put on too. That's what's in here. We haven't put any stickers on yet. We haven't done much of anything. We just got done with accessory builds. And honestly, when I saw this, I thought, oh, I don't feel like putting this thing together. Well, it's in my clutches. I have to put it together. Some kid's going to have fun with this. As for an adult, not too much. This guy's obviously a lefty. You know what? I'm going to put the camera right here because I'm working right here. Getting stuff in minifigure hands to me just doesn't work, although he wasn't too bad. And that's it. So we're building a My Little Pony, or a Ponita, but this one's like, looks like Darth Vader's pet. So yeah, it looks like bags one does that, and bags two through five are going to be building Pegasus. So let's get started. Step number one is this. And one of these. Not too bad, right? I think, honestly, if this was, like, maybe pink or something like that, it'd probably be a little bit more exciting than this ugly thing. Well, at least this manual, though, is, it's bound, and it's, everything's in one booklet, which is cool. So, Jay, you're going to have everything done this weekend. Or this week, get all these sets done now. Matter of fact, this one's working on the second week of all these. This is going to be my fifth out of 10. So, essentially, what's going to happen is when I get this one fully done, technically I'm halfway done with filming all these. And then I'm going to focus on the other stuff. It must be the torso or the, well, for Pegasus. We don't know yet. And when I go through and do the index and always look at the manuals too, I'm trying to find faster ways of getting reviews done. Because I really like to spend more of my free time though on the customs. Well, this looks yucky. A was something that LEGO did right there. Usually I put these in a call out, but they use step 10. They do 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 and put it in here. That's not a bad idea. I may have to do that on mine. Okay. Yes, I haven't got that stinking haircut yet. Gotta get that going. That's a chore. Oh, wait a minute. No, we're not supposed to put that there yet. Well, that's gonna be a bit of a bitch to get out. I thought, oh, this is gonna be quick, right? Because they have you shove that here. No, I gotta shove one of these in here first. Don't do what I did. And then, but so far, I'm, you know, except for the exception of that cage, the build quality for the most part on these sets that I've done so far have been really good. It's the build experience that stinks, but the build quality is really good. So these are meant to be played with. The thing I like about LEGO, though, you actually build toys with a toy. You're building a toy with a toy. It's like computer programming. You're writing a piece of software with a piece of software. Unless you're using Fortran, where you're using a punch card. Tonight, we're having chicken strips for dinner, and it's a home-cooked meal. Very unusual having all these. And today, I think, is the 25th of the... I think it might be the 25th. Maybe it is the 26th of September. I don't even know what day it is anymore. I've been working way too much. I'll look at the correct day here, and it's a Monday. I think the 28th might be a Wednesday, because I have something to do that day. So maybe it is the 26th of June, 2023. And okay, we're building mirrors for this. I'm glad now it told me because, see, they're mirrors. So I'm going to be working on the left one here. The left one goes on this side here. Sitting here and doing set after set is boring. But I have a guy in my community that thinks I'm kind of nuts because I don't like building sets all the time. And I like to build customs. Goes, well, but he tells me, though, customs are kind of hard. You can't see them like I can. I'm like, well, yeah, it takes a lot of practice. Only children and certain adults can do stuff in their minds. If you are, you're an artist. And this goes here. And then this one goes on this side here. It must be the body, the horse body, or the torso. And then, of course, we got more stuff. At least it's got some color in it, but. Let's see if that helps. There goes the old AC going off. Today's going to be like in the 80s. At the end of the week, we're going to be in the hundreds. I really got to get that haircut. I don't want to sweat with this helmet on my head. Well, getting that in there is kind of tough. There we go. Should have had me built it as a sub-step. There is some oddball colors in some of these pieces like these. But for the most part, though, it's mostly just gray, black, and magenta. Magenta's okay. It's the other stuff that I'm kind of frowning upon here. That's a nice color combination. And a 2x4 plate here. Just about done with this one here. I got a lot of my work done. I had a bunch of meetings I had to do today. It just felt like today wasn't going to end. And then coming home and doing this is not any better. Is there duplicates on this one? I don't see another 2x3 plate. So let's take a look. Okay, that looks like that's the head. And at least for the most part, though, I've got a lot of this stuff done. This is like a medium set, so after this one, I got to do one that's got about 1,300 bricks. It's short. It's a little shy of the last one we did. Like I told my friend, I said, you don't have to cook a meal every night. Because I like to, and I'm thinking, well, I don't have to. Wait. Hold on. We got not that, but this. And I was like, you know, we can always do something else. That's what it is. I think that might be the head. And, okay, this is not a duplicate. We got stickers coming up. I just saw them. And it's on a part that I don't want to put them on. And you know exactly what color a part that's going to be because it narrows it down. All right, so we need to take one of these and put sticker number 2 on it. And 1 and 2 are slightly different. And you want the arrows going up towards the top. Yeah, I will be ripping that off when I am done. Did I put that in the wrong area? I'll show you here. See how they have that facing up with the skinny part? Here's the skinny part here. Maybe it is right. Oh, I put mine on backwards. I'm not ripping it off. Sorry, Lego, but I'm not ripping that off. I don't need to be making these installments like long. So just be careful when you do your sticker orientations. Don't do what I did. So I'll just, so these are facing the wrong way, but I don't really care, to be honest. So this is supposed to be going down. I'm gonna do it like that. And so far, it's pretty sturdy. I can't break anything off. And black pieces sure show a lot of fingerprints. Yeah, so I had a fan probably about half a year ago, a few months ago, I can't remember, telling me to wear gloves on these. At that point, it's not a hobby anymore. It's more like a job. And this goes like that. So, looks like bag two does a minifigure. And Pegasus's torso. And that's what we have remaining. Alright, let's see what bag three has to offer. In bag two, we only use two stickers. We still got the capes. And I don't know, I don't see any minifigure parts. I bet they're in there. Oh no, we're not. Okay, that's even better. Okay, let's get going here. Let's see here, what are we building here? I'm gonna check real quick. I wanna make sure we're not building duplicates or something here. Okay, we're building the head next. Unless the source is special and has two heads, we don't have to worry about duplicates. Oh, that's coming apart already. And so far, the build is okay. Am I losing interest in it? Slightly. Just slightly. At least I'm being honest with you. I'm not telling you this is... I'm not telling you a flat out no, and I'm not telling you a flat out yes. Must be the teeth. Green teeth, so he never brushes his teeth. Always got to brush your teeth every day. You don't want them to rot out and you have to go to the dentist and waste money. We got some printed eyes here too. And the manual is just a tad on the slow side. Yeah, you're going to need a couple of these for a tutorial, not in that color, but you'll need them. Hint, hint. I forgot to mention that in the brick exploration, but eventually I'm going to, all these will be combined. Once I get everything over here, I'll probably do that. This will be Jay's Let's Build It. Or something like that. I mean, what are we doing? We're building a set. Let's build it. Let's review it. Let's dive right on in. The thing we're not going to cover is the... I don't know. I'm not going to cover on... theories behind the minifigures. I mean, I literally was in some of these groups. They'll build, and next thing you know, they'll stop, and they'll admire the minifigure for about half an hour, and you're like, really? Yeah, this is an interesting figure, and I'm thinking, oh, I can care less about him, but okay, you go ahead. I'm going to make me a sandwich. End up going, getting something to eat, coming back, and they're still talking about that same minifigure 20 minutes later. I thought, oh. It's hard when you got nothing but white pieces all over your counter. And trying to find a white piece on a white counter. Oh, I see it. And I have a feeling this is probably going to be a mirror here. Yep. Yeah, I'm starting to get a little more bored with it. Because all I'm looking for right now is black and white parts. The set has very little color. I mean, it looks colorful there, but the rest of it, I think I was going through it. I know I was doing the unboxing, I was like, guys and gals, you're going to hear the belly aching. I even warned them too, like, this is not looking good. I don't want to sit down and watch The Walking Dead. But I want to try to get this out of here before dinner time. And get it out of the way. So it goes like that. Is this thing supposed to be part bones or something? Kind of creepy. I mean, it looks like a horse head, honestly. Or a skull of one. Something you'd see in your nightmare, but... Yeah, but even doing the editing on these, I'm kind of like... When I get on the editor, I'm thinking, oh, I got to edit one of these things. Okay, be prepared. Okay, it tells me to pull it forward a little bit like that. See how LEGO does this with the yellow arrows? I have a template written up for my building guides for those now. So I've been doing that a lot more lately in mine, so it's not too confusing. And just something I'm trying to get... You know, when I write up my building guides, I'll run into like something new I have to do. It took me about 40 minutes to write everything up for that, but and that's in the pontoon boat. I gotta find the cone piece. Oh, it's white. That's why I couldn't find it. That would be steel or something. Oh, it's got the hollow stud. There we go. It does look like a horse head. You think LEGO would bring out My Little Pony? Now that would be... You know, I know a lot of guys are not interested in those, but for me, it'd be a good commentary item there. I think that goes right in there. Okay. It's like a sea serpent. Okay. And just a little spoiler, we got the ear out here. Before we do anything, I'm going to make sure what this is, and if this is a duplicate item. And that is essentially what it is. Okay. Let's get going. We're going to do them both in pairs. Listen. Remember, the recorder's over here, so here we go. You ready? There we go. Just making sure you heard that. So so you know, we got to do that again. Remember, we're doing a mirror here. Ready? There we go. Yeah, I'm hoping I can do a camper. It'll be a camper tour by the end of this year. It won't be a camper tutorial, but it'll be a tour. I like to save the camper tutorials more for the summer. I usually do one at the end, but I think I have a project that I want to... Okay, these are in the wrong area, obviously. I got a project that I would like to build, but I need to... there's one I want to build, be more related towards the holidays than a camper. Alright. And... Hold on. Okay. I thought I made a mistake. No, we didn't. I gotta put these on here. Yeah, I was looking at things to do in California and saw that there was a couple of craters that'd be kind of cool to visit. And I was thinking of more of a solo trip, but it's like a half a day's drive. And that'd be kind of cool just to go up there and poke around and do some scenic videos. And telling my bunch about it. And it kind of stirred up a bit of drama. Why would you do that? It's so far away. I said, oh, just something to do to get out of the house. Well, you got things around here to do. And I started rolling my eyes thinking, you know, I need to have a break from this. It's like, it's almost like I'm married. Like, you know, I do need a chance to chill out after a while. Oh, those are seamless. That's seamless there. Well, that really fits nice. Okay, well, that's something I've learned there. Too bad you can't get a windscreen that fits that. It'd make a great thing for a small little truck. Huh, that's not a bad idea. So we can obviously point out when I do the, when I start talking about the mock experience, that he goes like that. Okay, wait. Before I press that in, I would have really had messed up. Make sure this plate here is in the back. This is supposed to stick down. And then now I can commit. So you can annoy the parents with that. Do this on this side here, because we already, remember we already did the mirror. Okay, we already did that. Skip all that boring stuff. All right. And now, they want us to... Okay, want it rotated like this. And yes, if it doesn't look like these two things match... They show it in the book, too. I saw that, and I thought, wait, what? No, if you see that this one's black and this one's gray, the book shows it like that, too. It's just a limitation on the parts. And... Okay, we're building a mirror of horse legs. Okay. Yeah, so far it's an okay build. It's okay. It's just the colors are kind of making it kind of questionable. We'll have to see if we can have a little fun with this one here. So far we got a horse with some front joints and a head, and that's it. Nothing special. Okay, and we'll flip that over there. Yeah, I was looking at these two craters, and you'll have to hike to them. And I just thought, that sounds like fun. Now, the problem with these places is they're kind of in the upper deserts. And summertime, it ranges from, it gets up into the 90s. And if you've ever been desert hiking before, which most people don't, the one thing you have to remember is when you're in the desert and you're hiking and stuff, you have to carry as much water as you can possibly carry. Don't just depend on one little bottle of water. I always used to say, you know, get one of those medium bottles if you're going to want to stay hydrated. I always say two for every mile. So if you're going on a 3-mile hike, make sure you carry up to 6 bottles. And no sodas or anything like that, because that'll make you dehydrated. Alrighty, we gotta put stickers on these black pieces. I got plenty of these, but still, we'll put them together first so I can make sure I do it right. And that sticker number one, there we go, that wasn't too bad. There we go. All right, now we need some slopes. Isn't this exciting, huh? Feel free to fast forward if you find these kind of boring. You may miss out on the commentary. Okay. Now we got to put these together here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to match these up. And then I'm going to make another one for the other side. I'm sure these are probably duplicates here. And just do it like that. Okay. And you gotta fight this through here. Oh, that wasn't too bad, huh? I'll have to do it on this side too. Okay, I thought that would be a lot of resistance, like a lot of friction going in. No, that went in there pretty smooth. And yeah, you got the one-legged horse. Okay. Didn't say feet, I said legs, so. And then this goes here. That means that this guy goes here. Well, that's not going to work. Okay. There we go. Oh, I can back that up a little bit more, huh? Real. Looks like he's sitting down. Let's see. Let me get this backed up so you can see a little bit more than, you know, what I'm doing here. And he looks like a nice little horse so far, just the wrong colors. Oh, I'm sure the bronies would probably go after this set and make their own versions of My Little Pony out of it. Just download the building guide and there you go. Already got that done there. So yeah, this bag here looks like it does, I think, the head and the front legs. Oh, wait a minute. It goes like this. My bad. But there's two of them, so I'm just going to do it like that. So far, these... Oh, wait. These are mirrors. These are not mirrors. They're just... You just got clones. Clones, mirrors, or reflections. These are clones. So I don't have to worry about trying to mirror these. These. Okay. All right, let's see here. So these parts go down, this part faces back. Yeah, this would make a great little My Little Pony figure, huh? Just clean this up and change the colors out. So yeah, that's essentially what it is. Yeah. Oh, he can say yes. Does he say no? No. See, this is the horse that Pegasus will always say yes to you. See, and if he says, it's 3:30 in the morning, can I go hang out with my friends? He's only going to say yes, so that's how it is. And this is what we have remaining. All right, let's dive into bag four, and I forgot that. And so far, the build is... You know, surprisingly, keeping my interest up, it's just the colors. I'm trying to look past them as much as I can. And bag four, well, it's hard to say what we're doing here. Okay, we're doing the rear legs now. And yeah, so far, it looks like a horse. It's really sturdy. Although these feel like these are going to break, but... I mean, whoa. What person's going to sit there and manhandle this, huh? Maybe a kid would, but not for an adult. Actually, as expensive Lego is today. So we're going to go ahead and do the mirror treatment again. And I'd like to get through this as quickly as I can here. Just so I can move on to bigger and better things. Which means I got to do more reviews. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to start preparing these now. And this one's got the ear again. I can't deprive you of your ASMR pleasures. I gotta find the part first. It's all black within black pieces. Now, here we go. Try it and see here. There we go. Stick this one here. And we got one more to find. There we go. As long as the Technic pins are facing towards us, we're fine there. Okay. What, Lego? No 2x5 plate? Oh, wait a minute. We're sticking tiles. Or never mind. I redact that. Whoops, put that in the wrong place. At least the set comes with a brick separator, which is really handy. Is it a pleasant build? Yeah, I'm okay with it so far. It just feels kind of average in terms of that. And we're going to be building a sub-step here. I don't know if these are duplicates or not. It looks like it's just something. I think these are just duplicates. And honestly, though, in all fairness, some of the stuff that I build, sometimes the colors are a bit bland. because I try to copy things that we see in real life, and it's like looking at a, you know, it's like travel trailers, for example. A lot of the trailers I grew up with were white or tan. I never built a tan one before. I may have to do that. But I need to break away from building white campers, because after a while, the colors do get a little washed out and bland on them. Okay. Goes like that. That means that this one here goes like that. Okay. That doesn't make sense. Oh, it hangs over by a stud. So yeah, it hangs over a little bit there. Kind of, it's like, ouch. That doesn't look too good, but there it is. And we got a couple of Nexonite shields. Place those in there. And we got to put stickers. So I don't know how critical this is. So we got sticker 5 that goes on the left one. So kids, if you want to get tattoos, just remember Pegasus did it. You can too. You never catch me with a tattoo, but you know, this one goes on this one, which is sticker number 4. And working like this, sometimes there is a risk involved with making a mistake. Oh, wait a minute. We weren't supposed to put stickers on these. No fret, though, because guess what I can do? Just peel that up. There's a Nexonite shield underneath, and you got to put one on top. All right, so just peel those up. Like I said, there's risk involved here. I can't get that out. There we go. Make a mistake, you can just undo it. Hey, at least we didn't use crackle or glue or anything like that. There are some people who glue this stuff together. I won't. Okay. That sticks in there, but okay. And this one goes right here. Boy, that looks kind of painful, doesn't it? Doing the splits in the back. Yikes. So this one here is the one we did on this side. We just did that. Yeah, see? Looks pretty good, huh? We're almost done, too. There's no little progress bar on this. See these right here? I'm doing this in my manual now, but now I see how they did these. I got to learn how to do that with mine a bit more. Just learning how to do all this stuff now. And that's the only way to learn how to do this stuff. All right, so now it looks like we're putting together the feet. And I'm just making sure if these are mirrors. Yep. Now we can continue on with the build. Yeah, homemade chicken strips. Not like going to like some of the fast food chains. But sometimes having it homemade is just as good. It's yummy when it's homemade because you can make as much as you want. You can go back for seconds without having to swipe your credit card again. Okay, so this right here will also be flipped too. Okay, I just, oh, there it is. I was like, wait a minute, what? You know, I'm seeing all the other parts, but not that one that I needed. But when you're doing the mirrors like I'm doing, just keep them grouped up. Of course, this one's kind of universal, but still, it's almost like what we just built over there on the front legs. Okay, pretty good. And now we're going to have to put stickers. So I think the best thing to do is to put them on first, then put the stickers on. Because it just, and then I can get the orientation correct. So I got to put another sticker number one on here. So this one goes towards the front of it here. There's that. Got one more left. We still got two little stickers left to put on it too. So we got a long ways to go here. Because this is only bag four. Bag five, though, is not that big. You'll see when we get to it. First, I got to get through all the stickers stuff first. Well, that's okay. And then there we go. That white thing was so loud. Okay. Wait a minute, hold on. Stick that in there first. And just stick that in there. It looks scary, but it's not. It goes right in there real easily. There you go. And then that's it. And this one goes over here, trying to match this plate up here, and then it goes right in here. Yeah, it's starting to look like a horse now, huh? There we go. Missing some things, but there we go. And then we're done with that. And we got to build two of these. These are just two regular ones. It's like the front and back feet are the same here. What if you're missing one of these oddball colors, Jay? How do you handle it? If I'm missing a part and it's on my end, there's not a whole lot I can do about it. That's on me. If I'm missing a part and LEGO just simply didn't pack it in with the review offer, I would have to ding it. For the most part, though, I think maybe out of all these, I may have one piece that was missing. And I've been missing stickers out of some of these, too. Stickers, not so much, but the stickers on this set, for the most part, so far, are not hard to put on. The build quality seems pretty good, except for that thing over there. But for the most part, it's pretty good. Build experience is meh, you know. It's not the most exciting thing. It's the colors. And then and there you go. Kind of get his, I guess he sits like that, huh? So you can go like this. It's not top heavy too, which looks kind of creepy. And there you go. We're not done yet. You think the bag would end there? No, we got a little bit more here left to do. I'm going to take a look and see what we have. All right, so it's the tail. So this bag here does, well, I don't even remember at this point. You'll know when, I'll know when I get the, and then get the files indexed for you. Even I will know at the same time you probably will. Well, a lot of little snaps on that, huh? I mean, that's a lot of snaps there for this. This is the tail, and it goes right on that ball joint. Yeah, I do miss going into the mountains. I miss just getting up early in the mornings and going for the walk. Coming back, making a big breakfast, and go about my day, which essentially just is fun stuff to do. And these, okay, I'm holding it the same way that they tell me to hold it. Okay, they go like this. There we go, put it like that and push these together. Maybe that's some kind of pincher or something in the back. Well, I can't get that crap in for some reason. Then there's another one that goes right on the top. So I guess they're trying to simulate like it has really fluffy hair. Yeah, this thing's like a step down from a My Little Pony. Basically what it is. And yes, I've seen the animation of My Little Pony. I'll pass on it. Sister used to watch that. Okay. I think we're going to pick the blue story on this one. So how much of this we're going to rip off, I don't know. So basically, this bag here did all this. Not too bad. So basically, yeah. With the hammer nose, so you can take this and you can pound the brick stuff right into the table. and that's what we have remaining. Alrighty, let's do bag five here. Bag five first starts with the minifigure, and then we have to pick the story. You think they would have put the minifigure in here, but I think they were balancing it. And bag five, yeah, those colors don't look like they belong with this set. But there we go. And so far, I don't think, I'm just going to go ahead and when I do this, I'm just going to rotate them around when I do the review. You know, I don't need to go up close and personal on these. Yep, we got a cape we're going to have to put on. So everybody better get yourself a coffee. We're going to be putting this on. Still need to find some of these in white. Some of you recommended me using these for shower curtains. Well, I don't have them in white, but that's pretty close. You don't have to have a white shower curtain. Okay, I better not sneeze here. You have to work simultaneously to get that on there. Get that little kink out of the back. Yeah, I haven't made up my mind about getting that amateur license yet. I mean, I don't even know if I'll even have time to even really use it. But if I ever decide to go into the backcountry, it'd be nice to have it. I like the hair piece, the wig. Looks like strawberries. Maybe you could use it for strawberries, too. And we're not done with her yet. You got to put some accessories in her hands. So she's got some random carrot, probably for Pegasus, and she's got the hourglass so we can time Pegasus on when she can sleep. So when I do the tour on this stuff, I may just go ahead and I may do the minifigures and the small stuff first. And then we'll come in and look at this. We'll do this last. Do I need to put them on a turntable? I may just do it. And we'll go ahead and do the blue one here. And I don't think you have to take anything off of Pegasus yet. I'm hoping we don't. I'd like to be able to attach stuff on it as is, not take things off unless it's an accessory. You know. And we may have this one done quickly, huh? I may just do this one real quick and get it done. I mean, literally just get it out of here. I don't have to see it again. Sorry, Pegasus, but when I'm done with you, sweetie, you're going to get chucked into the parts bin. Remember Groot? Well, of course you wouldn't remember Groot. Well, he found himself in the parts bin. So what happened? He became part of my campground. You, I don't know yet. I do see some of those pieces that could be used for maybe some life preservers and some patio furniture. Yeah, Pegasus, you'll be part of the patio furniture collection pretty soon. The black pieces, I don't know yet. Some of that could be used for some kind of flower arrangements too. You'll be part of somebody's botanical build. Yeah. So watch it. We don't want nothing to happen, do we? I'm really surprised you can't buy Lego sets that are already manufactured for you, already put together. Of course, reviewing it, if I reviewed a set, it was already put together, there'd be no build experience. I wouldn't know the build quality and all that stuff. Is this a mirror? Okay. Glad now I checked. Because now I got mirrors to build. At least this one here has got some color. I know there's one of the sets that I kind of want to dive into that's from this theme. But I can't do it because I got to get this one done first. I'm doing small, medium, large. I like these leaf pieces. These would be great for some like tropical ferns or just big old plants. But I just don't have them in any of the nice colors yet. I mean, this is bluish green. I mean, I'd see these more for underwater themes, but I don't think I'd use these for like maybe a campground or a safari theme. We gotta make a sandwich. This is a leaf sandwich. Gotta have our greens or our greens and blues. Okay. And then okay. Looks like Mickey Mouse heads. Huh. And then we attach this one here. And of course, this one goes here. It's a little like a throne room or something. Maybe that's a throne. We don't know what that is yet. And then we skip all that. Looks the same. Yep, got that done right. Let's take a look here. And this is the head. Okay, we got two more stickers we're going to have to put on. You know, if I ever retire, I'm probably going to do the traveling gig more. Like, go to these places and just do a complete backcountry hike. Get a GoPro. Strap that sucker to my head. And then... And what I see, you see. What you see, I see. And then maybe have some talky videos like what I'm doing here. And then, so seven goes here on this side. Just thinking about that. Well, that didn't want to come off. There's one, and that would take care of the stickers. And a few of my buddies have housekeepers that pick up after them. I don't need to have a housekeeper. When I throw stuff on the floor, that's up to me to pick it up. So we got a handlebar to hold on to. Of course, you got it. Oh, no. I'm glad now I didn't do the green one. You'd have to tear all that off. Oh. Okay. Well, I'm glad now I didn't rip any of that off. All right. And that's it. So, basically, she just stands on here like that. So she can fly around and inspect Pegasus, make sure she's doing her job. Matter of fact, I think the best thing to do is when I do the tour on this stuff is to do what I'm doing here. Have fun with it. And that concludes this. So we did the blue storyline here. So basically, you can have something sit here and stuff like that. You know, and then the horse. Oh, the horse's head doesn't tip down for water. Wow, never be able to drink unless he goes like that. Oh, I guess that's a durability test, huh? Well, the head just came right off. Hey, at least I don't censor these. Boy, that really is kind of flimsy on there, so I'll have to let that be known. So be careful with that. You don't want to have the horse take a face plant. Okay. And stuff like that. So we got this little eagle thing, some kind of thing that flaps its wings. So, and purple bow and arrow. I think what I'm going to do, though, because there's three figures, is I'm going to break this thing down in such a way that we'll save the commentary for the review. So I think this is some kind of prison thing here. We got this bat. I think the best thing is to cover all these in their own thing. I'm like some of my viewers, though. Sometimes I think they throw a little too much in these sets in terms of builds. Because just this alone here would have been a set. And for the most part, everything is scaled. You can ride on this stuff. And this one here is kind of flimsy in terms of trying to make it stand upright. Trying to get this one here set up right. So yeah, this one here kind of just, I don't know. We got Pegasus, some flying things, and I mean, doing the tour on this is going to be kind of hard. I'm looking at it on the camera, so I can bring this stuff up like this and kind of show it. So I think, honestly, though, I don't think I need to spend a whole lot of time on the review. I don't think a lot of people are going to watch this. I'm not going to worry about it. More people are interested in the minifigures. So what I may just do, I may just come in and do all the figure stuff in one scene with the accessories. And I may do, or I could probably, let's just keep all the figures together. Maybe do these two things here, do this. I don't know. I always like to think of how I'm going to do the review on this thing. But let's start with the play value. It is playable. You can write on all the figures, and things do move around. You can do the horse. You can have them do all sorts of stuff. Wings move around. You can write on the stuff. So it's playable. City drop in value. I mean, it's isolated, but I don't see this being in the city. Ooh, excuse me. There's some value in mock potential. Not only you could build a theme around this, but there's some good building strategies out of this, too. For build quality, except for the head falling off and this thing here kind of collapsing, it is mostly a really strong build. Like, this is pretty sturdy here. Just the head is kind of questionable. Just don't have the horse take a face plant. And for my build experience on the set, I'd say it's probably just meh. No, I'd say it's average. Nothing special on it. Just, at least there is some colorful stuff. And so I'm going to say that this stuff here corrected it. It's a bit on the dark side, but the build experience is average. For me as an adult anyways, it's just average. Now, for collaborative build, bag one did essentially some of this, and bag five built this. Bags two, three, and four built the rest of this stuff here. Too bad they didn't have this divided up in such a way that you can do that, but it's not really a family-friendly or a collaborative build. Which brings to the final score in this set. There was some stickers. Some were a bit of a challenge to put on. Nothing scratched. Durability's for the most part is okay. I'd say 8.5. I'm going off of play value and accessories on this one. Okay, so 8.5. And for the price of $49.99, this is what you're getting. So I'd say it's about average. So this set's pretty much just an average set nonetheless. So, well, this is something I would be running out buying? Probably not. I'm not interested in the theme, really. After just doing a few of these, I'm kind of just like, yeah. But I want to know what you guys and gals think of these sets. And so far, I'm pretty much pleased with the build quality on these. But as far as for the color scheme, I'm not too much. It's meant to be a nightmare type thing, but still. I want to know what you guys and gals think. It is what it is.